But it looks like the guys at MotoNation stepped up, did a great job. It looks like Honda stepped up and really did good customer service here. Good morning, YouTube. This is Cruiseman. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, the channel for everything Honda Goldwing. I've said it before. We have DIY tips, motor vlogs, hacks, accessory installation videos. So if you love and are passionate about the Honda Goldwing, or you just like watching somebody who is, I'd appreciate it if you'd click on that little subscribe button down below. And if you click on the bell icon, YouTube will notify you when I come out with new videos. So this morning is kind of special because it's almost time for us to leave for Wingding 41. And my girlfriend's going with me. We're going to be heading out from the Dallas-Fort Worth area early in the morning, pretty soon. And I've been spending the last couple days getting the bike and the trailer ready for the trip. We're gonna be pulling a Bush Tech trailer, which is the one that I've had since 2007. Yesterday, I aired up the tires on the trailer. Today I'm going to try to get my license plate renewed for the trailer, because I haven't even renewed the license plate in a couple of years, because I don't really use the trailer that much anymore. It just kind of sits in the garage. And I'm going to go down to the county tax office and see if they'll let me renew my trailer for another year for the license. I don't even think they sent me a renewal last year. I don't remember getting one, or I probably would have renewed it. And now it's up to about $60 or $70, so it's ridiculously expensive. And you know, if you own a trailer, a trailer that you pull behind your motorcycle, put it in the comments down below. Do you have to pay for a license plate in the state you're in? In Texas, you do. And I think it's kind of stupid, but if we could make it to the border of Texas without a DPS officer seeing my license plate, we'd probably be okay, and I could make it the rest of the way to Nashville. Well, we're gonna take our time going to Nashville. We're gonna split it up into 3 days of riding. And we've got a couple of different routes that I've programmed into the GPS to go from Dallas-Fort Worth to Nashville. So one day we're going to go to Tupelo, and we're going to do the Natchez Trace the final day that we go up to Nashville. So we will be doing that, and hopefully get some good video. Oh, I meant to tell you, I'm going to be motor vlogging on this road trip to Nashville. Hopefully each day. I'm going to try to do one every day, maybe a day or two behind because of the time it takes to edit and everything, so I'm not sure how that's going to work yet. But I put together a special intro to kind of get in the mood, the theme of Nashville. So I've got a kind of a country western theme intro for my Nashville motor vlogs. So for those of you that can't stand country western music, you might be annoyed for the next few days. Of course, if you like country music, maybe you'll like it. So we thought we'd do the music for the videos to kind of be in the theme of the trip, which is, you know, Nashville, Appalachian country, kind of get in that mood, that feel. So you'll notice that in my next motor vlog, and hopefully the first motor vlog you'll see either Sunday or Monday, depending on editing time and what kind of internet connection we have to upload the video and all that stuff. So for those of you that have been kind of watching and keeping an eye on this situation with Wavy's 2018 Goldwing, I have not received an update yet.
I got back to the house after my Moto vlog this morning, and I had a phone call from Wavy and consequently an email. I just wanted to give you an update on the situation on his 2018 Goldwing that had the engine problem we talked about in the last couple of Moto vlogs. As it turns out, it looks like that Honda and the dealership really did step up on this issue and are really addressing it and getting Wavy taken care of, which is really, really good and exciting news. I'm just going to read the email, not word for word, but I'll read a lot of it that I got from Wavy's because I don't remember the names and all the titles. But the senior district service manager, Norm Henkel, of American Honda, personally came to Memphis to meet with Wavy and Chris Caliente, because Chris had taken the bike in his trailer over there and been helping out with this also. It came there to meet with Wavy, and they met and had a meeting. And apparently this is like just an engine situation that's like a one-off defect, manufacturing defect, that it's the first one they'd heard of. And Norm apparently got Honda to overnight the parts to MotoNation, who is the dealer. And the service manager of MotoNation, his name's Bo, and his team tore the engine down to the block for inspection and replaced all the necessary parts. Bo and his team worked numerous hours and even worked after hours and got the bike back together in only 1.5 weeks. This is a pretty remarkable achievement because Bo's team is possibly the first dealership to tear an engine down to this point. So on a 2018 Goldwing. So anyway, it looks like the guys at MotoNation stepped up, did a great job. It looks like Honda stepped up and really did good customer service here. You know, these are mechanical things. Issues are going to happen from time to time. There are manufacturing problems that occur. So I'm really, really happy to announce that it looks like pretty soon Wavy's going to be riding his bike again. I think they're going to be test riding it for a couple of days just to make sure everything's working just right. Honda's going to take care of it. It's all warranty issues. So I think it's really good news. I can't think of any better news to get ready to go to Wing Ding on. So anyway, just wanted you to have that update. Congratulations to Wavy. Thanks to Chris Caliente for him helping out too. And thanks to Honda and MotoNation in Memphis.
I should also remind everybody, for those of you interested, here's my shameless plug, and that is that the August promotion for the 2018 Plus Goldwing maintenance videos ends tonight at midnight. So this is your last chance. If you want to get the save the money on the 2018 Plus maintenance videos, now's your last chance before they go off. So Friday night at midnight, it will be over. And I should also remind you that many of you have taken advantage of this promotion over the last couple of weeks, but some of you did not use the promo code. Again, this keeps happening. You're paying the full price. You're not taking advantage of the August promotion. So if you paid full price for the videos and did not get the promotion price, once again, you just need to send me an email and forward your email from Vimeo, the email receipt you got from them showing the price you paid and when you purchased. And we'll make sure you get a rebate, or we'll take care of it somehow. So if you did not take advantage of that August promotion, just email me and let me know. I'll put the email address in the link or in the description of this video. So, lots of cool stuff coming up. I'm anxious to get to Wing Ding and go to the trade show and meet some of the vendors there and some of the folks we've done videos for in the past and will be doing videos for in the future. And like I said in my last video, this will be the first time that I've done a road trip with my girlfriend on this 2018 Goldwing. It's also the first time that we will be using the Cardo Pack Talk Bowl to communicate with each other. That'll be the first time for that. In fact, I don't think we've ever done a road trip with Bluetooth headsets. We've always used the corded system back on the 2012. So that'll be different. I tried everything I could. I've tried putting both our helmets in the trunk every way I can think of to position these helmets, and I cannot get my IS Max 2 and her Arai 3/4 helmet to fit in the trunk. And she has a small, I have a large, she has a small. I cannot figure out any possible way to get both of these helmets into the trunk. And I know some of you have sent me pictures where it shows two of these IS Max in the trunk at the same time. I don't know how, I mean, I see how you did it, and I tried to do it that way. I can't get hers to fit, so I don't know. I'll try again. But right now, it looks like we're going to be using lid locks for at least one of the helmets. And I like lid locks. I have it over here on my left handlebar. It's a good system. The only thing is I don't particularly like leaving the helmet out in the weather. You never know if it's windy. Maybe it could blow up and start banging on the bike. Or if it starts raining, of course, you're going to get water in your helmet. You know, just stuff like that. So that's about all for now on our MotoVlog this week. I appreciate all of you guys that subscribed. I appreciate all of those who watch the videos and you take the time to put in comments and give me feedback on what you like or don't like about the channel. Even if you criticize or have something that you want to say about me that you don't like, I'm okay with that. I know that's just part of the deal. So anyway, I will be checking in with you from the road on the way to Nashville for Wing Ding 41. And we will see you. Oh, and don't forget, like the video. Give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed this. And we'll see you on the road to Nashville.